as we continue, whenever a thought crosses your mind, just notice that it's there and return to your breathing. Now begin to pay attention to the in-breath. Notice that at the end of the in-breath, there is also a tiny, almost imperceptible pause. And just notice that. Now at the end of the out-breath, just count. One at the end of the first, two at the end of the second, and so on, up to 10. When thoughts cross your mind, simply notice them and return to your breathing. Try to come to a sense now of your whole body breathing. Pay attention for a time to that feeling. Finally, just breathe freely for a minute or so, and whatever thoughts cross your mind, simply return to your breathing. That is the end of our practice. Thank you.
You guys might wonder at all. Do you guys have a hard time staying concentrated when you're breathing? Do your mind go in all different directions?
Yeah.
It's tough. It really is. But it really does get easier with time. It really does. So, like, that's just an example there. Like I said, there's hundreds of these out there. So, you know, sometimes even just doing something like that is enough to kind of give you a sense of calm or a sense of peace. So I would definitely encourage you guys to explore some options. Real quickly, you guys do have an evaluation to fill out, but you all should each have also a little piece of paper. Did anybody not get one? I think a couple of you came in and I didn't get you one. So how many of you guys have heard of like the adult coloring craze? Anybody aware of that?
Yeah.
Okay, so there are adult coloring books out there for those of you guys that didn't know, which like I've loved color as a kid, so I think like I need to try this. But it all came about because of mindfulness. There's this artist, I think she's from France, and she started designing these coloring books for adults because it's kind of like art therapy, if you've ever heard of art therapy, but it's a good way to just kind of focus on something other than everything that's going out and on in the world. So I have a adult coloring book to give away. So that's what the paper's for. If you guys would like it, you're free to put your name down. I'm gonna pass a cup around. I figured if somebody wouldn't use it, then you don't have to put your name in. Because. But if you would like the adult coloring book, you can put your name in and I'll draw all of your names. These actually are relatively inexpensive. I got this one on Amazon. I think it was $7 or $8, so it wasn't crazy expensive. But if you liked to color as a kid, that might be a good way to relieve some stress and focus on mindfulness now. So. And then once you guys finish your evaluations, you just flip them upside down and leave them. Or you can leave them in a stack over there before you go. And if anybody missed the sign-in sheet when they came in, make sure and sign it on the way out so we get your contact in for this. If you guys have any questions or thoughts or anything you'd like to share? Okay, somebody should draw for me.
Kendrick.
Hi. There you go. Enjoy coloring. You're welcome. Yeah, and I think there's lots of like, if you don't want to buy a coloring book, you know, there's the coloring sheets. You can go download coloring sheets. But yeah, you might give that a try. All right. Thank you guys for coming.
Cool. Isn't it you guys going to the 215 we did that? Do you know where we're supposed to meet at?
I think it's just downstairs.
Because I know you can go through the gym or go through the outside.
I never have gone through the gym. I'm afraid I'll get lost.
Thank you.
Where would you like? You can just set them on the table over there.
Okay. Dory, thank you.
I did a class one time that was guided imagery, and it was like one of my favorite things that I've ever done, because we would just go.